Welcome to Joby, a movie and a bottle of wine.
Hey everybody, it's Joby and Matt and the cat, and we had another splendid week of movies, I must say. Last week was awesome. Matt took me to the movies last week, and there were good movies in the red box.
For what?
I rented them this week, but I didn't get to watch all of them, and I'm going to go sequentially, so we'll start with Lizzie Borden. It was okay. It was another Lizzie Borden movie, and just like I said, this one had an aspect of the girls kissing and such, and maybe that was some kind of teamwork between the two girls. But say bye to the cat.
Bye, cat.
She's going away.
Cat!
Cat!
Huh? Wait, cat, don't go!
I don't think she liked this movie
either. We got her in the beginning of the video, so at least she was there. So.
If you watch the other Lizzie Borden movies, this movie was good, but it gave motive for her being with the servant girl. I don't know. If you watch the other Lizzie Borden movies, honestly, I don't think you missed anything.
My favorite was the one with Elizabeth Montgomery, the lady from Bewitched. That was a good Lizzie Borden movie.
I can't remember if I saw that one. But this
one, I'll have to find it for
if you saw Matt's movie, this one was not worth watching. It's just a replay.
Okay.
I watched one that I really enjoyed. It was called I Still See You. It was a great story. It was like ghosts. They called remnants. There was some kind of something that happened, and all these people who were within a vicinity of whatever happened died. And their remnants stayed there. So, like, the little girl would get up every day. Well, she wasn't a little girl. She was a teenage girl. And she would get up every day, and her dad was sitting there having a cup of coffee and reading the paper. And then she got a little boyfriend who was really interested in the remnants. And he studied them, and he broke some key factors in the puzzle. It was really interesting. The boy in it looks like Christopher, a very young Christopher Walken to me.
Hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. Wait till you show some stuff from the movie, Matt. You'll see.
Yeah.
You'll come back
we're
next
gonna
week
check
and you'll
that
go.
Out. That sounds
he
very
does.
Familiar to something that I wrote. One of my stories, but that's okay.
But it was really neat. They would drive through them and they would vanish and disintegrate. Really cool. Really good story. Really good actors. You'll watch it from beginning to end and not regret it.
Okay.
Down a Dark Hall that had Uma Thurman in it had these girls who were going to either go to girl jail or they were going to go to this place. It was a all-girls school, and it was spooked, and there was stuff going on in there and scary things, and it was pretty good. It was interesting to see Uma Thurman in a different role.
Hey, you had me at Uma Thurman.
Yeah. I mean, it wasn't Kill
I'll
Bill.
Watch it.
It
yeah,
wasn't
no,
Kill Bill.
No.
It wasn't the other stuff
but Uma
where
Thurman,
she's super pretty.
Sure.
Some of it, she's super pretty. No, she was the marm of the school.
Okay.
And the girls had to either go there or go to jail. It was really good. Down a Dark Hall. One that I watched this week that was a twist on a twist on a twist was called A Simple Favor.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
I liked it a lot. It had Blake Lively and Anna Kendrick in it. And the little guy that was in it, it was his second movie. Really good. He did a really good job. He had to play between these two girls. I watched a shitload of special features about this. It was talking about their love triangle and their relationship and all this stuff. But it was a twist on a twist. On a twist.
Come on, baby. Let's do the twist.
I mean, you watch it and you're just kind of like, I got it, I got it, I got it, I got it. But each actor and actress in this movie is suspensefully awesome. Very, very dark.
Nice.
The guy that produced the shows went on to introduce the special features, and he was a very interesting person. Murder Suspense, it was actually a book. And if I didn't mention in the I Still See You, that was a book. It was called Break My Heart a Thousand Times. And this book I didn't get the name of for a simple favor. The music in it was really cool. It had this cool French music. Beginning to end and all through the credits, the little French music was really... It really had you going. Je te passe les limites, mais je ne parle toujours pas. It was really cute.
Wow.
Matt and I watched Night School tonight with Tiffany Haddish and Kevin Hart. Oh, I don't even need to say anything about that because, of course, that was so good. It was so good.
Yep, yep.
I mean, she was really a caring, thoughtful teacher in it, and he was trying his hardest. And together they worked and got him through night school and got his GED. It took a long time. It took a lot of tests.
Yep. Yep.
But he finally passed it. And to wash away the time, of course, Matt and I had some wine tonight.
Did we?
Yay!
Oh, okay.
Were you drinking last night?
Yeah.
Did you get drunk last night?
No.
So Matt and I had cocoa bon. Of course, I had to bend all the way over to the floor to pick this up. Bed Kroger, because it
you
is on the
thing.
Bottom shelf. Now, I went over into the wine area to get Brownie Points wine, but there was no Brownie Points wine because evidently everybody else likes Brownie Points wine as much as I like Brownie Points wine.
You bastard. You deprived us of Brownie Points.
You bastard.
I like it more than them, but they beat me to it. So Coco Bon was right next to it.
It was fine. It was fine.
I bought a 4-pack of this. Hold that for me, Matt.
Okay.
And I bought a 2-pack of the Yellowtail Smooth Red Blend. If you guys remember, I've reviewed both of these before. Mm-hmm. I got this one over at Fresh to Frozen when they had the Yellow Blend on sale. I got a tremendous deal on it. Tremendous. I paid as much for this bottle as I did for the large bottle at Fresh to Frozen. So hopefully... they'll get back up with the Yellowtail people and get us a good deal on that wine again. But this Coco Bon Red Blend and the Yellowtail Smooth Red Blend. But of course, to wash it all down.
No, not again.
Strawberry Lemonade Loko. And I made an error last week. I thought that I bought this at Sheetz, but I thought I bought it at Wawa. But I bought it at Sheetz.
I was not exactly right.
What do you mean, not right?
I mean, not right.
I don't get you.
You mean you were wrong?
It's $2.69. It's like a dollar cheaper at Sheetz than it is anywhere else. So you guys go to Sheetz and get this cool green bag. You can use it when you clean the cat box to get the poop in to put it in the trash can.
That's what I was thinking.
And they give you two of them.
That's exactly what I was thinking.
It's two litter box cleanings
here.
And you save a dollar on your sheets. Four Loko.
For the
Shazam.
Four Loko Sweet Strawberry Lemonade. Sweet lemonade.
Sweet lemonade. Sweet lemonade. Sweet lemonade. Yeah, sweet lemonade.
You're going to love it. You're going to love it. I've got some other movies that I watched this week.
Every drop, you can't waste a drop. God forbid, a
every
single drop you wasted.
Every sperm is sacred.
Yes. What?
And as my name tag says.
Oh, she's got that lovely name
movie
tag.
Movie critic, wine specialist.
That's right. That's right.
I have a name tag for that. So you guys go and taste these things or you're missing out. I watched a couple of previews this week that I found to be quite fascinating. I'm going to be looking for them in the red box. One was called Blind Spotting. You can Google that. It looked funny. It looked really interesting. It's very new. And Hellfest. I couldn't come up with anything to describe that one. You just have to Google it and see what you can put together from it. Blind Spotting and Hellfest. that I'm going to be looking for them, and you'll see them when I review them. I think that's everything from your movie critic / wine specialist.
It's printed. It has to be true. It has to be true. If it's printed, it has to be true.
I'm glad everybody came by this week. I hope you appreciate my reviews. Yeah?
I was going to interrupt you and say this is episode 69.
How could I forget?
69.
Episode 69. I was born in 69. It's very special to me.
Yep. That's right.
Saturday is my birthday, my son's birthday, my dad's birthday, and we're going to go out to eat at the Golden Corral, my dad's favorite place to eat. What could you want?
No, no.
What could you not want? Yeah. It's all there.
And this is your last episode before Christmas, so Merry Christmas, everybody.
Glad you came by.
Yeah.
Put some mistletoe on.
Ho, ho, ho.
See you in the new year. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
69.
Thank you for watching Joby, a movie and a bottle of wine.
It was a twist on a twist on a twist.